Hi, this is Milan Salvii. In this episode, I'll show you how to create a lower third in LumaFusion using a video with a transparent gradient as its background. This is 100% done in LumaFusion without using any other app. As you can see, the video that serves as the background appears solid on the left side and progresses to full transparency towards the right side. After creating the lower third, I'll show you how to export it using HEVC with transparency so it becomes a reusable asset. Here's the lower third that you'll be creating in this tutorial. With the lower third being transparent, just drop it on a track above a video of your choice, and you are done. No keying or opacity adjustments are required. This is how the lower third looks after adding transitions and text. Let's get started with a new LumaFusion project already containing the video that will be used as a background for the lower third. For simplicity, I'm using a 15 seconds long video. If you're planning to show your lower third for a long period of time, choose a video that loops so you can put one lower third after another. The purpose of the next steps is to incorporate a transparent gradient to the video. LumaFusion doesn't currently have the ability to create gradients, with or without transparency. The transparent gradient will be created with a combination of different layers of the same video, applying different levels of cropping, edge softness, and opacity. The reason why multiple layers are used, and not just one, is that edge softness of one single layer is not enough to create a gradual transition from solid to transparent. First, let's create a tool to check how the changes that we'll be introducing affect the transparency of the final result. This tool is just a title with a white background covering the entirety of the screen and a black horizontal line placed in the middle. Now, make 5 identical copies of the video that will be used as the background for the lower third and place them one after the other on the main track. Now, you have 6 identical copies of the video. Take the leftmost copy of the video and place it above the transparency check title. As we start building the transparent gradient, concentrate on this area. This is the area that will be used for the lower third. Edit the video. Inside the cropping section, adjust the value of right to 10. This is because the end result should fade to transparency a bit before the right edge of the screen. Increase edge softness to 100. Now go to blending and change the opacity to 20%. Exit back to the timeline. This is how it looks so far. Notice that the black bar in the transparency check title is fully visible at this point. Now bring another copy of the video and place it on the third track, just above the previous one. Now we'll follow a similar process, but with a bigger area being left out of the cropping and slightly less transparency. Edit the video. Inside the cropping section, adjust the value of right to 22. Set edge softness to 90. Now go to blending and change the opacity to 40%. Exit back to the timeline. This is how it looks so far. Notice that the black bar in the transparency check title is still fully visible. Now let's repeat the process for the third copy of the video, cropping more and making it less transparent. Follow along with the video. Now, two more times for the fourth and fifth clips. Follow along with the video. This is how it looks so far. As I mentioned earlier, this is the area that will be used for the lower third. As you can see, we have a nice gradient on the right side, but there's also a gradient on the left side that we don't need. Let's remedy that. We don't have any more tracks, so move the stack of videos to the main track. At this point, you can delete the transparency check title. Add the last remaining untouched video to the top of the stack. Edit the video. Inside the cropping section, adjust the value of right to 70.8. Considering the area that will be used for the lower third, now you have a nice video gradient that goes from being solid on the left side of the screen to fully transparent on the right side. Export the project selecting HEVC with transparency as the codec. Open a new LumaFusion project and add the video that you just exported. Edit the video. In the cropping section, set both top and bottom to 41. You can use different top and bottom cropping values to get a taller or shorter lower third. Now adjust position Y to lower the video to the position you want it to be. At this point, the lower third is ready. Export the project selecting HEVC with transparency as the codec. You probably noticed that I didn't include any animation to transition the lower third in or out. There are two reasons for that. First, this way you have the flexibility to set the duration of time the lower third is displayed without being constrained by the timing of the animations. Secondly, it gives you the freedom to select different transitions every time you use it. Here's an example showing how to use the lower third that you just created. Start with a new LumaFusion project and add a video of your choice. Add the lower third asset that you just created on the track just above it. The lower third will run for 15 seconds. If this is too long, trim the video. Add the slide right transition at the beginning and end of the lower third. Each of the two transitions should be 1 second long. This is how it looks so far. Now, add a text of your choice to the third track. For a nicer effect, use keyframes to animate cropping so the text is revealed at the same time the lower third is revealed. Do the same thing for the end of the lower third. This is how it looks all together. So this is it for this episode. If you like this video, please consider subscribing to this channel, give it a like, and click on the bell so you're notified when I post new videos. Thank you for watching, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next one.